On a brushed DC motor, we add two wires, apply a voltage, and it spins. On a brushless motor, however, we have three wires. So does that mean that they're power, ground, and signal? Nope. Okay. Maybe it's for reverse and ground. Okay, no. It's more complicated than that, but not by much. In this AddOhms episode, we're going to look inside of a brushless DC motor and talk about how you can control them. Sometimes you'll hear a brushless DC motor called a BLDC. As their name suggests, there are no brushes. The commutation occurs electrically, not mechanically. Wait, what does commutation mean anyway? Well, using the Google, we can see that commutation is the process of commutating. Seriously. Okay, commutate comes from the Latin word exchange, and that's the key. Commutating is interchanging the current through the coils to make the motor spin. So let's get back to the BLDC. Remember, there is a rotor and a stator. In this design, the armature is part of the stator. When the current flows through the armature, a magnetic field is generated, and that allows the rotor to, well, rotate. So the three wires from the outside connect to the 12 coils in this design. The coils are arranged in a pattern that keeps the rotor moving. The difference from a brushed motor is that there is no commutation ring. This means that three external wires are our only way to keep the rotor spinning, which means you can't just apply a DC voltage to any pair of them. Now let's simplify and talk about just three coils. Electrically, they have a common connection, with three external connections called U, W, and V. Each connection gets two transistors, one connected to ground and one connected to the supply voltage. This circuit is similar to an H-bridge. Just like that, we can use a specific pair of transistors that allows us to control which coils are turned on and which direction current flows. It's just a matter of developing a sequence. Backing up for just a second, I should point out that each of the coils is called a phase. Since there are three, this is a three-phase motor. Our internal examples show 12 coils, which is still a three-phase motor because they are connected in groups of four. You may also see a single-phase BLDC, but we'll come back to that. Now this circuit, you could build it using discrete MOSFETs and then control the speed with a microcontroller. However, you probably want to just use an ESC instead. Okay, I swear, I'm not trying to make this video a complete alphabet soup. An ESC is an electronic speed controller. Here I have an example from my quadcopter. Inside of this yellow package are the transistors, decoupling capacitors, and some circuits to help control the sequencing. For a connection to a microcontroller, I just need to connect a PWM signal. ESCs can be designed with many other features like a electric brake, the ability to reverse, or special ramp curves. The point is, in most cases, when you use a BLDC, you'll also want to use an ESC. Here's a typical brushless motor that pretty much breaks everything I've just said. It's a standard fan, maybe one you might use in a PC build. It's a BLDC. But unlike the quadcopter motor, it's a single phase. And you might notice it only has two wires. Yeah, okay, sometimes they have three, but the third one is just for temperature. So how can this be a BLDC and only have a positive and negative wire? It's because inside of the motor are the electronics that do the electrical commutation. The main positive to a brushless DC motor is that there are no mechanical brushes. This means no internal sparks and almost nothing to wear out. Now, controlling them means a little bit of extra added cost, but you know, the external controller or built-in driver, that's not going to be very much. In a future AddOhms motor tutorial, we'll look at stepper motors. And personally, these are my favorite kind of motor. And the reason is it's basically a brushless DC motor. So when that video is available, I'll let you know. All you have to do is subscribe to this channel or follow AddOhms on all the social medias. And in the meantime, if you have questions about motors or other electronics, leave them with this video or visit the AddOhms forum. And remember, if you can't figure it out, just AddOhms. Maybe I should say AddOhms one more time.